work, the action turned on by Amir Khan in the final 45 seconds was phenomenal. Switch step roundhouse kick to open up for the Singaporean in the black trunks.
Expect Amir Khan to shift into a different gear in this round. He's got the conditioning. Song Jong Lee looks a little bit fatigued, looks a little bit tired. Khan looks very relaxed, very fresh.
Could we see a contender here for the Go Daddy knockout of the night? Khan still peppering with the jab, threading it well. Changes angles, beautiful dipping left hand, hoping for the liver of the Korean. Then goes back upstairs. Jab two kangaroo from Amir Khan. The high kick.
I'd like to see Khan go up high with the right kick. You can see Song Jong Lee starting to drop his hands a little bit, especially in some of these wild exchanges.
The lead hand of Amir Khan tonight has been a thing of beauty. Trucking elbow. The knees now from the Muay Thai clinch. Song Jong Lee drops down, hoping that Khan will follow him. And Khan doesn't want any piece of that.
Song Jong Lee's putting himself in a bad position in a lot of these, like, sort of sacrifice, pulling guard type maneuvers that he's doing. Oh, nice left hook there from Song Jong Lee. And again, he pulls guard again, but now Khan's a little bit slippery, so he slid right off.
Don't forget, Amir Khan brought three Japanese wrestlers to Singapore to prepare for the takedown defense. And he's showing it well at the moment. The training has paid off. An extensive count for Amir Khan. But guts and intestinal fortitude here from Song Jong Lee of South Korea.
Yeah, Michael, but he brought in takedown wrestlers, people that were trying to push him up against the cage and take him down. Song Jong Lee is attempting some very interesting little scissor takedown there into a leg lock. He's got that good grip on that heel. Look at Khan trying to run away. Oh, he chooses to sit back down.
The first hammer fist there from Amir Khan.
Possible calf slicer here on that right leg of Khan. This is a painful position to be in right now.
All tied up like a demented game of Twister. Khan just glances over to his corner. What are they telling Khan to do here, man?
Look at that leg. He's like, all right, trying to sit up out of this position. There's a full calf slicer on the right leg of Amir Khan. Very painful move. He's got to try to get his hips away and slide out. Song Jong Lee is crafty on the ground, man. Some of these submission attempts, that scissor takedown, impressive. Now he's going after the heel hook. It looks like it's a straight leg lock.
Leg locks are the specialty of Song Jong Lee.
Achilles lock there, puts a lot of pressure on that Achilles there, right below the calf muscle.
Amethyst strikes, elbows from top position, still the legs tied up of Amir Khan. 2 minutes remaining here in the second round. You know that Khan wants to find a way back to his feet, Mitch.
You can see Song Jong Lee's got the legs triangle. Now he's going for a cross body Ashigarani, maybe, from that position. That's what it looks like. Trying to extend the legs there. Going after that's where he's going after. Going after the heel hook on that side.
1 minute 40 now. Still Song Jong Lee playing the leg lock game. Looking for the Achilles, looking for the heel, looking for the knee.
Look at it. That's a heel hook right there. Look at Khan trying to roll. He's trying to get his leg down, and he does just that. But now you would almost think that Benario was naturally a wrestler and a grappler. Big head kick there, just barely misses Benario, slid underneath it. And again, he goes right in for the takedown. This is definitely something that we're not used to seeing. Benario consistently shooting for takedowns and not throwing those heavy hands and kick strikes.
A lot of Filipinos who get into the fight game started off just messing around with something that I think they call buton, which is a form of wrestling. And that is where Benario started. Kevin Beling on as well very much had that kind of a background before being schooled in wushu and transforming their activities to a striking-based martial art.
Here he is in the half guard of Jartim. So he's gonna wanna try to pop that leg out. He's got the right leg inside the half guard of Jartim, so he's gonna wanna try to slide that knee out, pass into side control. Our team's doing the right thing by turning onto his side so he's not lying flat onto his back. Good reversal by Czech team to end up on top.
It's a great effort from the Czech fighter.
Benario just stands right back up and throws Czech team up against the cage.
That's the strength of Benario. Oh!
Ready, go!
And they're all behind one shin, Shannon Wurujai. Wurujai in southpaw stance, the tall, gangly, beanpole Indian in orthodox stance. Shannon Wurujai said he did more sparring in training in this camp than ever before.
Five three-minute rounds. We've had one of them. Potentially 12 more minutes to come, and judges will score this round by round using the 10-point mark system. The exchange of kicks early in this round, and the pace has increased as compared with the first 3 minutes. Sam A has really stepped things up.
And Sam A going back to the low kicks, chopping on the long legs of Roland.
He got a bit of a surprise towards the end of that round, didn't he? And maybe that just told him that he needs to just move things up a level. It's a marathon, not a sprint. Five rounds here, and Sam A knows that better than anybody.
Roland not phased at all by Sam A. He's throwing back strikes of his own.
Just getting caught on the top of the head, stumbling back into the wall of the circle. What a prospect facing Sam A. Going to head out. You just cannot hide. We'll catch up with you.
Oh, no, then look for a spinning elbow.
Twice. Gianni, and he wasn't far off, but Sam
great A. Left. Oh, great left by Sam A.
And sent that left in towards the chin. It doesn't look to me as if Roland's getting up.
Seven,
he's on his back,
eight,
arms to the side.
Nine,
we're at the count of 10, 9, and it's over. With 100 seconds left in the second round, and I must say, that was an absolute exhibition.
Second round of three on the one fantasy game. The fans leaning in the direction of Janet's side by 59% for the win tonight over Ekaterina Vandereyeva. This one scored on a 10-point must system. So the winner of the round gets 10 points. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. And you score it, folks, wherever you're watching live in over 140 countries around the world, from TNT in the USA to Skynet in Myanmar, Toggle in Singapore, Star Sports Select in India, all over the world. For one century, the largest martial arts show ever. Not just pouring with that lead hand to set the right hand or the right roundhouse kick. It's the right roundhouse kick to the lead leg of Vandereyeva. Vandereyeva skipped forward, didn't commit, however. Looks for the inside leg, it takes one to the outside leg, around that sciatic nerve there, does Janet. Vandereyeva, a graduate of Belarusian State University, a degree in tourism management. Go! To use it, though, in the last 6 years. Applying her trained as a professional Muay Thai combatant around the world at the very highest level. IFMA 2009 gold medalist, 2010 WKN world champion.
Go! Beautiful combination there thrown by Janet. You can see a little bit of damage on the left side of her ear there. I think she got clipped by Vandereyeva. She was throwing that serious exchange.
Nice knee on the inside of the left leg here from Janet Todd. They tango, center of the circle. Referee Onari breaks them.
Go!
K1 fans may recognize referee Onari from back in the illustrious K1 days. He was a mainstay on what was then the biggest kickboxing stage in the world. Now, of course, it is one super series. And we are seeing a very high-level Muay Thai contest at the moment. Hook to leg kicks there from Vandereyeva.
Janetai just did be a little bit tighter in her technique. She's able to land shots right up the middle, just like that. Beautiful jab to a body shot.
There's a very interesting technique that.
Oh, hey, it's awesome!
Smack back from Janetai! Vandereyeva laid out in the circle! Referee Onari puts the count on! It's the Dano Reign!
guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.